I just wanted to quickly say, I've known Michelle for many, many years, a few years. And she is such a treasure to this community. I have worked with her, I have admired her. I was speaking to Philip the other day and I was telling him about when I first came out and I didn't know anything about drag, and but there were house parties. Nothing in the club, it was house parties. And you'd go to a house party, or at least I went to a house party, didn't know anybody, I was just kind of standing in the corner with my boyfriend, and everything's going on, and then all of a sudden, this phone call would come in on the little Vista phone, you know, the speaker, right? And somebody pick up the phone, and then all of a sudden you hear, Michelle Lattimore! And everybody would stop, the lights would come up, the music would shut off, and everybody's standing there in a room full of people, you know, parties going on. And we'd be speaking to Michelle through the Vista phone because she was in Puerto Rico or Switzerland or someplace off doing her thing. And we're like, hi Michelle! And Michelle, hello! Hello everybody! And I did not know who this Michelle person was. I just knew that everything stopped in the world when Michelle stepped into the room. And she came back. And she had did her first show at El Cubeto Rico. It was her first time back, and I was there because I wanted to know who this Michelle person was. And the love in money, this whole place was full of money. Everything full of money. And I really just wanted to know who this person was, that everybody is just showing so much love and appreciation for. She got people to get up and dance. She got people that don't smile to smile. This is who she was. Michelle has always been at the top of her game. As long as I've known her, as long as I've seen her perform, she's at the top of the game. And I respect her, I love her as a friend, I consider her a friend. We've sat down together, we've had conversations that I'm not going to repeat up here. And they were funny, she is comical, she is sweet, she is a businesswoman, and with all the queens that are around now, she is still at the top of the game and teaching young things. For those of you, some of you may know that I've dabbled in drag a little bit. And when I do drag, I want to be as good as Michelle Ross. So I just wanted to say that. I appreciate you, you are my friend. I know.
She got me start crying and I got these emotions.
And I love you and you know I appreciate you and you are all my family and everybody in this room right now. Everybody around the world that you've been to and seen. Everybody that you're going to see tonight at the club, even if they want to say that they don't appreciate you, they model their shows towards you.
Yeah.
They have you at every club. They book you all the time. You've been booked since like
last year.
And you're still booked. And the reason that you're still booked is because you are legendary. You are an icon. You are respected.
Yeah.
And you are loved. Woo. I just want to say before I go, thank you guys for fighting for us. Because I'm not out there. I'm also done. I just do my thing and go home. When you're 35, it's hard.
Michelle.
And shout out to Black Cat, honestly. Black Cat is the legend himself in the community, honestly. One of the most consistent and incredible performers and DJs that we have for sure in the city. So shout out to him.
Keep going down. I'll go down with you. I'll go down with you when you go down. So, I'm going to just hug you.
Mm-hmm.
Everything Black Cat said that even more, because when I came to Toronto in 1970, I went to parties. That's how I was inspired to do a lot of what we do.
Oh,
and I know you were holding it down for all of us.
Thank you.
You were a home. You were
I'm still trying.
When all of this wasn't going on, you were holding it down. So you were the earliest activist that we know.
Thank you, darling. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you.